Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You're watching Flutic. Newly releasing custom ROMs and the custom JSR builds are really giving tough fight to stock OEM skins like iOS, OxygenOS 15, nothing worse, and the Google Pixel UI. From few days, we are releasing the videos of universally supported custom JSR and the custom ROM videos, which are changing the world of custom ROMs. But the most popular AOSP custom ROM known as Evolution X has decided to beat not even the world of custom ROM, but also the Android skins like iOS, OxygenOS and the nothingOS. In the currently released build of version 10.3, they started to add all the amazing and unique features that resembles the features like depth wallpaper, lock screen widgets, QS panel of OxygenOS 15, iOS and nothingOS. So you can customize your device the way your most favorite Android skin out there in the market without losing some unique customizations of the Evolution X that are not even offered by the Android skins. Today in this video, we are thoroughly going to review all these features, and at the end, we have shown what's working in the JSR. It's very important part because even though this is a JSR build, it's fixed almost everything. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. I have given the list of all the officially supported devices in the video description which got this new Evolution X 10.3 update, which includes all the devices like OnePlus 6 and the OnePlus Nord 2. But other device users, don't worry, I have also given the custom JSR link which can be flashable via DLC loader and it should work on any device. You can check the iCard video for the detailed flashing process of JSR build on any Android device. So my OnePlus 9RT booted with the new Evolution X 10.3 using the DLC loader. Let's check out the about device details of this build. This is the Android 15 base ray Evolution X 10.3 build. Security patches are also updated to the latest February 2025. The amazing thing of this JSR is that it has its own kernel version 5.4.254, which is built with the latest client toolchain 11.02. So this JSR build has its own stability, optimizations, performance, irrespective of stock kernel. In other words, this JSR will act like a pure custom ROM instead of custom JSR. Its build date is of 15 February 2025. Now let's start with all the new amazing customizations of Evolution X and the features of OxygenOS 15, iOS, nothingOS and the Pixel UI. The customization hub of Evolution X is available in the Evolver option of the setting. Under the theme setting, we get the first new feature called as the wallpaper styles, which resembles with the nothingOS and the OxygenOS features called as the wallpaper blur effect. Currently, it's buggy in the JSR and only works with the both the settings for the lock screen and the home screen wallpaper. You can add the glass or the frosted blur effect to the both the wallpapers using this setting. You can check in the video, it's giving the amazing look to your home screen and the lock screen. Next is the unique setting of the Evolution X, it's a brightness slider customization. It offers a new different styles of the brightness slider. You can check some of the custom effects of the brightness slider. All will completely evolve the look of your QS panel. Next is a new notification style option. Here we can add the iOS style notification to your device. But in my opinion, Cyberpunk, Duoline and the layer styles are something unique and this is not offered by any stock OEMs out in their market. These notification styles also completely change the look of your heads up notifications. Compact heads up toggle will show you the compact heads up notifications. We can expand this notification by tapping on it. We get the complete chat of notification if these notifications are from chatting applications. Next are the new power menu styles. By using this, you can convert your power menu style to the iOS. But we also get the three different options like Cyberpunk, Duoline and the layers. You can take a look up all of these styles here, but my favorite is Duoline. Next is a unique feature which is now only available in the latest released highly customizable ROMs. It's a boot animation setting. You can now able to add your own custom boot animations, or you can use some old most famous boot animations like Cyberpunk, Sanijun Mod, Pac-Man and the Valorant editions. Under the lock screen setting, you get the lock screen clock faces. You will get some of the amazing clock faces from all the OS. Especially, I liked the never settle clock face of Oxonus 15. We also customize the versions of these clock faces. These all will give the amazing look to your lock screen and on the always on display. Another great feature of this ROM is the new always on display images, which resembles to the Oxonus 15 always on display customizations. You can add any image to the AOD and it will be displayed over the clock face on the always on display. Here our channel's logo looks amazing on the AOD. And you can also customize your lock screen like your own way using these amazing features. Lock screen widgets is another great feature which will beat the nothing OS lock screen widgets. Enable the lock screen widget toggle. Below it, you get the device info widget. If you enable this, you get the device widgets which shows the battery, RAM status, device temperature and the CPU load. It's not an interactive widget, means it only serves the purpose of showing the information on the lock screen. We can customize the look of these widgets to the different styles like square, rounded and translucent. But the amazing part of this setting is that we can add 2 big and 4 small widgets. All of these are interactive widgets, means you can toggle them on or off straight from the lock screen, like torch, Wi-Fi, hotspot, data, etc. Even the Oxonus 15 and nothing OS didn't even have such features. Next is Navbar. This is another great addition by the custom world. This is interesting interactive widgets of ongoing activities on your device. Especially it's useful to show the media files like music playing on your device. You can backward, forward or can even pause or switch between the audio devices directly from the lock screen. You can change the position of the navbar using the navbar level slider. Navbar not only shows the media files but it also acts as the charging notification panel. Navbar, clock face and AOD images with the device information widgets are remain visible on the always on display, which gives the amazing look to your always on display even better than the nothing OS 3.0 lock screen widgets. Next is the iOS depth wallpaper. I already created separate video in the details how to use this feature. You can check it from the iCard. Just enable the depth wallpaper toggle, select the depth wallpaper which has the only subject without background. Then apply the same wallpaper which has its subject and the background. Set other settings as I told in the iCard video. That's it. Now you can enjoy the better version of iOS depth wallpaper on your Android device. In the quick setting, you get the new QS widget toggle, which will convert your device QS panel to the Oxonus QS panel. It will add the Wi-Fi and the Bluetooth rounded shaped tiles with the brightness and the media volume sliders. These are fixed widgets. Below them, you can access your all the QS panel tiles, which are flexible and can be edited using edit button. Even you can able to change the clock styles of the QS panel header, similar to the Oxonus clock, using the QS header clock style setting. We also get some other amazing clock style in this setting. Next are the Pixel devices exclusive features which can be added by using the miscellaneous setting. In the component spoofing, you can spoof your device as a Pixel device. Enable the toggle named as the Pixel props and the tensor features. Now you can use almost all the Pixel exclusive features like circle to search, Google Gemini, unlimited Google Photos backup and even more. Evolution X already added the Pixel Launcher in their OS, so you can use all the Pixel Launcher features in your device. This time Evolution X team already enabled some tweaks, so almost everything is working in my device, even though I am using the custom GSI version. It should work for your device also. Like device integrity check, safety net, both are working. Device Play Protect is certified. All the sensors are working. Only issue I got is no fingerprint is working, but we have working face unlock in the GSI. Network is not detecting my device because of no baseband issue. But I have one solution to solve the network issue that I will show you in another video. This is all about the new Evolution X, which is evolving as better version in the Android custom ROM world and can even beat any Android skin. So I can say in the upcoming days, you will definitely forget the Oxonus 15, Pixel UI, nothing OS and the iOS. This is all about today's video. If you guys like the work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for the notifications of our upcoming mod content for all Android devices. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.